Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to our channel. We are Nicole and Mico. If you saw our last video, you'll know that we have been exploring the city of Osaka in Japan to see what exciting adventures the city has to offer.
In today's video, we'll be taking a day trip from Osaka to Nara, which has many beautiful historic temples and also possibly the world's friendliest deer.
Come here, deer.
Cookies.
Your cookies.
We're going to spend our whole day's budget on deer food.
We don't need lunch, do we?
Nah.
Watching Claire get attacked by the deer just did not look fun.
So the best way to get from Osaka to Nara by far is using the trains. Right now we're at the Osaka Namba station, which is pretty much a central station here in Osaka, and we should be able to take a JR line over to Nara. It should only be 30 to 45 minutes. And it's a pretty direct trip with just one train ride.
Woo! We're going to Nara!
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you know they flew?
What? You mean we could have been sitting with the guy this whole time?
Alright, before this train gets going, I want to say that we are taking the Q line, which is the Yamanotoji line, from JR Namba Station to Nara. I think we're on the right train.
Mico has organized everything to make sure we get there perfectly. I think it's gonna go great.
I actually have no idea what we're gonna do with Nara, though. I haven't gotten that far.
We're gonna see deer!
That was extremely fast. I think that probably took, what do you think, kind of like 30 minutes?
35, I would say 35.
35 minutes, and like now there's not a building, like tall building in sight. Like it's like the landscape is completely transformed.
Welcome to Nara.
All right, ¥580,
and we made it.
That's really good. It's pretty, I'm impressed.
It's a cheap day trip, guys.
So before we get to the deer part here in Nara, I just want to quickly say that in the Shinto religion and also according to local beliefs, the deity Takamikazuchi arrived here in Nara on a white deer. And the result was that the deer was considered very sacred and religious. The locals here believe that they are a messenger of the gods, and they have been protected here for over 1,000 years. The deers here in Nara and around the shrine areas are especially protected, and their learned behavior of bowing in order to get a treat has made the spot into a very famous attraction in Japan. We are on our way now to just like the park area of Nara, and it is so beautiful here. This park is just so inviting and so green, and there are a ton of deer already. I think this is the place where you can start feeding them and get even closer to them.
So I'm not completely sure yet how I feel about the whole like human and deers like coexisting so intimately. I love it, I wanna love it. I'm a little nervous that it's gonna feel like, I don't know, unethical, but from what we understand, we can get some food, and I think it's just made out of like two ingredients, barley and I think wheat, so like very natural ingredients for the deer to eat, and like they are wild deer, so they just eat the grass and stuff as well, like they just have their normal diet, but there are so many here, look at this. Can you see them all behind me there? So many people with food feeding deer.
I was gonna get three.
Oh, wow.
Taste it.
I don't want to taste it. It actually says in line humans probably shouldn't eat it.
Not gonna lie, those deer look a little pushy. I think they've developed a good taste for these crackers.
Yeah, I think they seem very pushy. I think I'm actually a little nervous we're gonna get bit or smacked.
You've been bit before, right?
Claire's been bit before.
Right here.
Right here, actually, let's go find that deer.
Yeah.
Big act time.
You go first, Claire.
Alright. Oh, you're getting fine. Swarmed.
Are you gonna bow? Are you gonna ask him to bow?
Oh boy.
Oh my god.
think those crackers are gonna last that long.
All right, double crack. Oh, okay.
Claire, there's another one.
You have to ask them to bow. I'm trying.
You're getting surrounded. They're not bowing.
Claire's getting attacked. We got four deer on her now.
They're gone?
They're gone.
Okay.
Well, that was an interesting feeding experience for one of us here. Nicole's now looking for a deer that's calmer, more tamed. I don't think they're here in Nara.
I really want to find like a calm, sweet, nice deer.
You're not gonna find like a Bambi out here.
Watching Claire get attacked by the deer just did not look fun. Okay, like that looked way too aggressive for me. It's not what I want my deer to do. I just like ran away and held my cookies. Like, no.
Claire's like, what a beautiful moment in Japan.
Target acquired.
You must bow.
Oh, nice job, baby.
Show the dog. Yeah. Falcon. Oh. What a sweetie!
So, in case you're unaware, in Japan, and here in Nara, the deer do bow to people. And all you have to do is have a cookie, and you bow to them, and they bow back, and they just learn how to do that with the for the tourists and the locals, and it is super cute. So that's a big reason why people come here.
Okay, now sit.
Oh my bow.
Maybe you can teach him another trick.
Okay, if you don't want pets, I want pets. You want paw?
Oh, target acquired.
That's it. No.
This one is a really nice one.
No. Yeah.
If you come here, find this one.
Okay,
you very, very good job. I thought you were supposed to be nice. What are you doing? I'm like clapping to stop the deer.
Oh, wow.
That's a good head shake, back.
Okay, tell me your eating experience, or your feeding
comparison.
Experience. Yeah,
let's compare the experiences.
Calm and sweet.
Mine was like adorable. Claire was so excited to feed the deer that she was like, let's just buy the food and feed the deer. So you just like grab the package, but then they're all like, yes.
Yeah, because I think Claire, because you have that big stack, and you're like, order up, everybody, order up.
It's basically like, it's like in a hamburger full, like for the deer. It was probably not the best approach.
But it probably was a good video.
It was probably a good video. Meanwhile, I actually had a really nice experience. That was calm, just me and the one deer. At the end, I got a second deer.
Yeah, and it was nice.
But it was really nice. I mean, he like eats pretty ravenously, like as if I'm gonna leave right now, but it was really sweet. We're gonna spend our whole day's budget on deer food.
Yeah. We don't need lunch, do we?
Nah. All right, everyone, let me take a minute to introduce you to the sponsor of today's video, Manta Sleep. Manta Sleep makes sleep eye masks, but these are not just any old eye mask. We've each been using the Sleep Mask Pro every night for the past 4 months, and we have come to love these things. The Sleep Mask Pro is designed to be completely blackout and has these C-shaped eye cups, so that means there is no pressure on your eyes when you're wearing it. The masks are super adjustable. You can move the cups around and they just Velcro to any part of the mask. And then you can also change the mask's overall size using the adjustable strap as well. I also love the little bit of rubber at the back that ensures that it doesn't slip off my head at night. We both chose to get the Sleep Mask Pro because it suits our travel lifestyle, but Manta sells all kinds of sleep masks, including a cooling mask, a weighted mask, silk mask, and they even have a Bluetooth sound mask. I personally think that the Sleep Mask Pro looks a little funny, but honestly, we just don't care because these masks are amazing and have hugely improved our sleep no matter where we are in the world. So if you are interested in getting your own sleep mask, click the link down the description and use our code NicoleMico for 10% off your order. So Kofukuji Temple, which is a Buddhist temple, I think actually it was first created in like the 600s, but it was interestingly moved multiple times, like disassembled and then moved to different parts of Japan a couple of times, but it's been here since like this early 700s from what I understand. It's beautiful, it's a beautiful temple complex. It's just a nice place to stroll around, take some great photos, learn a little bit more about Japan's history, just meander.
Wow, we did not expect these guys here. Apparently you can just find the deer right in front of the temple. I'm not gonna lie, I do feel a little bad for the deer with like all these people crowding them. I think I saw a woman try to get a selfie with the deer.
He keeps like trying to fall asleep on himself. And then falling off.
kind of reminds me of like trying to fall asleep in an airplane. It's just, there's just no comfortable way of doing it. Not gonna lie, this is a pretty cool grounds area, but it's just, it's cool to just walk around. But although we feel like it is a very touristy place, more so than the places that we've been in Osaka and Tokyo, Nicole and I were just saying that like, it's those places are touristy, the attractions in those cities, but I also felt like there were a lot of locals around. Here, I feel like it's exclusively just for tourists. However, it is still a beautiful place to walk around, enjoy the different buildings that are here, and also the deer.
Okay, so we're just walking down the street. There's tons of restaurants, cafes, shops, and I managed to find a little like pastry of some kind. This looks so good. It's still a little warm. You could have got it stuffed with whipped cream, but.
It smells so good.
Oh my god.
It's like a cinnamon bun.
Oh wow.
Oh wow. That's delicious. I think you should go for the whipped cream though. I think that actually be really good. They're warm. Oh man, so we got like rice cake. It's like a pound of rice cake. I don't actually know the name of this dessert, I'm sorry. And on the inside, I think is a soybean paste. And they're warm and they're fresh. I think it's quite famous to get them from this particular spot. This looks so good. Like, look at the feel of that. It's like, how like, it's mushy and like...
It looks like a Play-Doh.
It feels like Play-Doh. Oh my god. That's amazing. Look how gooey it is.
It is.
It's so good. It's like... just soft, a little bit sweet. It's like chewy.
The outside is chewy, hey? Mm. Oh man.
It's almost like dough.
It's like dough, but it's not cooked.
Nice.
It's very good. Ooh, highly recommend.
This is the rest that Nicole gave me. This is all I get.
You're on a budget.
We're on a budget, so we only buy one. It's only 180 yen.
Dropping red bean paste on the ground.
Mmm, looks like deer poop now. So I don't know if this happens every day, but it seems to be a day where there are lots of student groups.
Hey guys.
Hey guys.
Hey guys.
What are you doing?
Okay. Look how many there are over there.
I've never seen this many people and deer in one space. All right, so where are we going here?
I have no idea.
It's a little overwhelming.
There are so many people here. But this place is beautiful. I guess it's from the 1200s. And I don't know anything else yet, because it's in Japanese.
This is how Nicole and I do our research, just on the fly. But I do know we are coming up to a very famous temple here, and we have to go through this massive arch, which is really, really cool. Looks like it's made out of very, very old wood. That's my perceptive research right there.
I'm surprised. I feel like every place we've been to so far in Japan, it's been restored in the last little while.
Yeah.
So it looks so beautiful and like perfect. So it is interesting to see a temple, while the temple gates
look old.
Yeah, like yeah. Properly look old. All right, guys, so this is Todai-ji Temple, and I looked it up. I think it's from the 600s or 700s. So it's been here a really long time. It's really beautiful. It's actually most well-known because it has the tallest bronze statue, which is a Buddha, in the tallest wooden house in the whole world. I think it's both, the tallest bronze statue in the world and the tallest wooden house in the world. So you can enter and actually go inside the temple because it's just kind of the outside facade. It's 1,000 yen though to get in and actually see the Buddha. And it is super busy here right now. So we're gonna take a pass on the inside. The grounds themselves are absolutely stunning as well though. So it's definitely worth coming and just kind of looking at the outside if you don't feel like going in, same as us. It is a really beautiful place.
Come here, dear.
Nicole's trying to do a funny photo where she stands on the stump and she gives a cookie to one of the deer, but there are no deer around, but so she just kind of thought she'd stand on the stump and then eventually some deer would come, and look at that. We've got some deer migrants already.
Hello. Oh, you're a very good deer.
Queen of the deer.
You're a very good deer. You are also a very good deer. Oh, that's my leg.
So I'll be really honest, we kind of had a lazy afternoon after the last temple because there was a lot of people, it was really hot. We decided to just get a coffee, and instead of looking around Nara a bit more, we decided to just come back to the deer park and feed some more deer. And this is just going to be the relaxing way they're going to spend the rest of their day. So if you like this video, make sure you give it a like. If you want to see more videos of us in Japan, make sure you subscribe. We will see you in Kyoto. Okay, sit. Oh, they have such tiny little teeth.
I don't think you're gonna learn. Teach him how to sit.
Sit.
No.
Oh, okay, no. Oh, I don't have any more.
Oh.